you said about us being afraid of flying, does that somebody have to do with life being transient?
Life being
transient.
Transient, wonderful. The question is about death. Yes, always. Because the brain has nothing of its own, all it gets is what it gets from the outside, external. You remember, A is B. The brain has nothing of its own. All that the brain gets is from time and others. When we say space, we mean brain gets something from another person or situation. And when we say time, then we mean that brain has a collection of your own memories in the past, right? So whatever the brain has, it gets only from time and space. Nothing of its own. Look at it. It will always be afraid, because what comes from the outside can go back to the outside. What time has given you, time can take back as well. So the brain forever lives in misery, in suffering, in apprehension, that insecurity. And it is because of that insecurity that it wants to project the future. Remember, all fear is nothing but the fear that something will be taken away from me. And hence the greatest fear will be that I will be taken away from myself. A mobile phone is taken away from you, you are afraid. Something bigger is taken away from you, you are more afraid. What when you yourself is taken away from you, then you are greatly afraid. The thing with the brain is that it has nothing of its own. All its identities, its sense of the self, itself comes from the outside. Itself comes from the outside. So it is forever afraid that something can be taken away, something can be taken away. Related to that, that someone else told me that I am successful. Now this success can be taken away. Hence, death happens to be a great, great fear to the brain. It knows of itself only as a physical being. Only as a physical being. Now, the physical thing did not come to the brain out of its free will. It was a, what you would call a random event. You didn't decide to be born. Did you decide to be born? Did it happen out of your free will? Because it happened accidentally, hence there is a great fear of death. Do you get it? That it just came to me and it can go back at any time. This fear of annihilation is what the brain will always live in. Brain will always live in a fear of extinction. Always.
Is this the reason for inertia and energy?
No, inertia is a property of matter. And brain is completely material. The brain, we said, is always afraid of that which it has not experienced. Whatever is new will terrify the brain. All of you sitting here are afraid of death, am I right? Now, how many of you really know death? Nobody. Because really to know something, you must be in contact with it. You must have had a personal taste of it. That none of us have had, right? So all we know of death is coming from the outside. Some images that time and space have given to us. Something that you have seen in a movie or in the locality or in the house. None of you really know death and you are still afraid of it. Isn't that funny? But that isn't funny because if you don't know it, it is new. And the brain is terribly afraid of the new. Brain is afraid of the death because death will be new. Not from the past. The brain does not know death. So it is afraid. It does not know what is there, what is death. Hence, deeply afraid. Otherwise, tell me, how can you be afraid of something that you don't know? And do you know death? You don't know death and are still afraid of it. Is that intelligent of you? Is that intelligent of all of us? To be afraid of something that we have no understanding of. None of us have passed through death and yet we are afraid of death. Whatsoever is new, the brain will be so afraid of it. And the brain will greatly welcome what is already contained in the past. It will want the patterns of the past to continue for the future.